Guys, in this video, we want to look at the benign or chronic hypertensive retinopathy, the clinical features. So basically, what we have seen so far is hypertensive retinopathy, what exactly hypertension is, what retina is. So systemic hypertension can lead to some damages in the retina. So we want to see what exactly the damages will be. Mainly the arteries of the retina, you should know where they are and all that. So basically, all these arteries will suffer because of hypertension, right? And what will happen is, there can be increased vascular permeability, hemorrhage, exudates, edema, right? All these problems can be there. Papilledema, optic disc swelling, all this can be there. Why this hypertension happens? Vasospasm can lead to hypertension. Arteriosclerotic changes can lead to hypertension. Okay. So, something like this we have to look at. Okay. So basically in the clinical features, we want to look at the benign, the features of the benign or chronic hypertensive retinopathy. Malignant hypertensive retinopathy, basically a sudden increase in in the blood pressure, rapid and very large increase will cause a malignant hypertensive retinopathy. However, in this video, we want to concentrate on the benign or chronic. That means slowly but increasing long time it has happened. That is chronic hypertensive retinopathy. Benign or chronic hypertensive retinopathy. In that, we will look at the clinical features. Okay. So, first of all, why does it happen? See, in old people, because of involutionary sclerosis, it will happen in old people. But in young people, if this hypertensive retinopathy, chronic hypertensive retinopathy is happening, they are pointing it to be associated with some benign nephrosclerosis. So something to do with the kidney, right? So the changes in these young people will be called as albuminuric or renal retinopathy. See, this word is renal retinopathy, okay? So they are calling it as renal retinopathy. In young people, if this happens, so it could be associated with the kidney. In old people, this is senile sclerosis involutionary. Okay. Now let us look at what exactly the changes you will see in this condition. So generalized arterial narrowing. So generalized all over arterial narrowing will be there. Focal arteriolar narrowing. So focal means localized, right? So basically, focal arteriolar narrowing is seen in areas of localized vasoconstriction. Okay, so you can read all this. Now in generalized arterial narrowing, what did you understand? All over, right? This is also called as attenuation. In this, there are some phases, guys. Vasoconstrictive phase and sclerotic phase. They are talking about vasoconstrictive phase and sclerotic phase. So guys, in this vasoconstrictive phase, this occurs due to diffuse vasospasm. So there will be significant elevation of blood pressure which persists for an appreciable period and increase in retinal arteriolar tone. Okay. So because of vasospasm, all this will happen. Then sclerotic phase, due to intimal thickening, hypoplasia of tunica media, hyaline degeneration. Okay, so this is characterized by what? Arteriolar narrowing associated with tortuosity. Okay, so it's pretty clear, guys. Vasoconstriction because of vasospasm, etc. Sclerotic phase because of sclerosis. Pretty clear. But basically, it is generalized everywhere it is happening kind of thing. Now, coming to focal arteriolar narrowing in areas of localized vasoconstriction on the disc, right, and within half disc diameter of its margin zone. So specifically they are telling where it can happen. Now coming to arteriovenous nicking, this is the hallmark of hypertensive retinopathy and occurs where arteriole crosses and compresses the vein. So basically, let us look at this photo here derived from internet. So basically, this is the hallmark of hypertensive retinopathy. So arteriovenous nicking is the very, very important term. So wherever this arteriole crosses the vein, it will compress the vein. Okay, so you can see here. So you can see here, wherever the artery is crossing the vein, the arteriole is going to compress the vein because artery has more blood pressure, correct? So it is going to compress the vein. So, This happens because the vessels share a common adventitious sheath. This is also known as AV crossing. Interesting, like AV crossing. So here you have some signs called as Salu sign, Bonnet sign, Gun sign. This Gun is very common in ophthalmology, right? Marcus Gun sign. Remember all that? So Salu sign, Bonnet sign, Gun sign. So basically what will you see in Salu sign? Deflection of veins at the arteriovenous crossing. So there is a deflection of the vein. Okay. Then what is Bonnet sign? Bonnet sign is banking of the veins distal to the arteriovenous crossings. And what is Gun sign? Tapering of veins on either side of the crossing. Okay. Guess if I'm not wrong, the vein is actually represented by a slightly darker color. Okay. So this seems to be the vein. The darker color, and the artery seems to be more reddish. So there's a nice diagram here found from the internet again. Look at this one where they have tried to explain these signs. Salu sign. What did you see in Salu sign? Salu or Salu sign? Deflection of veins at the arteriovenous crossing. Deflection of the vein. This looks a little deflected. Okay. Bonnet sign, banking of veins distal. So in Bonnet sign, there's a banking of the vein. Okay. Distal to the, they're telling it is banking of the vein, distal to the crossing. So this on one side they have shown banking. That means there is some kind of a banking. Actually, the word means a heap or something where you're putting everything, kind of a thing. So you can see the distal part of it only is banked. This is Bonnet sign. This is purely my understanding, guys. Lastly, let us look at the Gun sign. Either side, it will be tapered. Either side of the AV crossing, it will be tapered. Look at this diagram. If you can see any Gun sign here, either side of the AV crossing, it should be tapered. This actually, I can see some tapering. If you consider this is the AV crossing, see the vein, which is the darker colored, it's suddenly very thin here, right? It is tapered, that you can see here. Bonnet sign, let us say this is the Bonnet sign. You can see the vein, here it is thin, but here it looks very thick. So this is purely our understanding, guys. You should do your own research about this, okay? So, what is Salu sign? Now we forgot what Salu sign is, right? Salu sign is deflection of the vein. Deflection means it is going to a different direction. That's what I think. Okay, this kind of a, see how they have made it so deflected kind of a thing. Okay. Now let's move on. So arteriovenous nicking we have seen because of this hypertension, chronic hypertension, all this happens. Then we'll come to arteriolar reflex changes, arteriolar reflex changes. So we have read in the beginning that some arteriolar reflex will change, but we didn't know what, right? The normal light reflex of the retinal vasculature is formed by reflection from the interface between the blood column and the blood vessel wall. So basically, this is the blood vessel, right? There is blood in this. Okay. So because of the reflection from the interface between the blood column and vessel wall, because of some reflection here, when you put light reflex, you will see some normal light reflex, okay, from this arterioles, okay. But now there is some change. That's what they are saying. There is some change in this arteriolar reflex. See, normally it will be bright and thin, linear blood reflex, okay. Normally it will be bright and thin, okay. What they are saying is bright and thin, linear blood reflex is seen normally over the surface of the arteriole in young age, and predominantly this is because of blood column in the arteriole, since the vessel wall is by and large transparent. So what you will see normally will be as the blood vessel will be transparent and inside there is a blood column, so it will be looking how bright, thin, linear. Okay, now what happens? More diffuse, less bright reflex. It's not going to be that bright and it's going to be more diffuse. So it is seen because of thickening of vessel wall, and this represents change in grade 1 and grade 2 hypertensive retinopathy. So in grade 1 and grade 2 retinopathy, you will see more diffuse and less bright reflex. So look at the light reflex here in grade 1 and grade 2. They are saying this is grade 1 and this is grade 2. So it should be less bright, the arterioles, right? Less bright reflex. The reflex is less bright. It will be more diffuse because of the thickening of blood vessel wall. Okay. So it will not be so bright. Okay. It becomes a little dark, all of these arterioles. Next, where are we? Here. Copper wiring. Now let's go to copper wiring, silver wiring. Some specific terms are there here. Copper wiring and silver wiring. So here we are. Copper wiring, silver wiring. Let us look at copper wiring. Reddish brown reflex of the arterioles occurs due to progressive sclerosis and hyalinization, and it is a sign of grade 3 retinopathy. So copper wiring becomes grade 3 retinopathy. So you can see here, this copper wiring, it looks like a copper wire. Like inside there is a wire and outside there is a plastic kind of a thing, I think. Copper wiring, reddish brown reflex of the arterioles occurs due to progressive sclerosis and hyalinization. This is grade 3. So first one, more diffuse and less bright. They said grade 1, grade 2. Copper is grade 3. Now let us move on to silver wiring. Okay. So silver wiring, look at this photo now. Silver wiring, it looks like a silver wire. You can see the border of the wire, you can't see. It is totally looking like a silver wire. Opaque white reflex. This is a white reflex of the arterioles. Occurs ultimately due to the continued sclerosis and is seen in grade 4 hypertensive retinopathy. So this is grade 4, as simple as that. So copper wiring in grade 3, silver wiring in grade 4. More diffuse, less bright reflex, grade 1, grade 2. As simple as that. Now let us move on to this one. Superficial retinal hemorrhage. Flame shaped. Okay. Hemorrhage. So there will be hemorrhage. Where is this? At the posterior pole due to disruption of the capillaries in the retinal nerve fiber layer. These hemorrhage disappears in 3 to 5 weeks. So there is some hemorrhage. Obviously hypertension is leading to hemorrhage. And then what are they telling? This can disappear also. So here they have shown some flame shaped hemorrhage. Guys, we have taken this photo from the internet. Look at this flame shaped hemorrhage they are indicating. Okay. Superficial retinal hemorrhage, flame shaped. Then let us move on to hard exudates. Here they are talking about some hard exudates. Okay. Hard exudates. Can you see here? They are talking about some hard exudates here. So this is going to be the hard exudates, right? Hard exudates. So basically, lipid deposits in the outer plexiform layer of retina, which occurs following leaky capillaries in severe hypertensive retinopathy. So obviously, the capillaries are leaking. So there is lipid deposit in the outer plexiform layer of retina. So you know the outer plexiform layer of retina? So this is the outer plexiform layer of the retina, right? Here you have the pigment epithelium, cones, rods, the nucleus of these cones, rods, then you have the outer plexiform layer. Here they are telling we'll have the exudates. Lipid deposits in the outer plexiform layer of retina occurs following leaky capillaries. Okay, this happens in severe hypertensive retinopathy. How do these appear? These appear as yellowish waxy spots. It's pretty clear here, right? Yellowish waxy spots with sharp margins. They are generally seen in posterior pole and may be arranged as macular fan or macular star. Okay. They can be like macular star, macular fan. They are also temporary and they also disappear after 3 to 6 weeks. Okay. Then we have to look at something called as cotton wool spots, guys. So we are done with hard exudates. Now let us look at cotton wool spots. Okay. So here again, and we are referring to this photo only. Cotton wool spots. Look at this. Cotton wool spot. Here, guys, it looks like cotton wool, right? That white. So these are fluffy white lesions and represent the area of infarcts. So, okay, this is infarcts. Now, ischemia has led to infarct. Area of infarct in the nerve fiber layer. So, nerve fiber layer has this problem. Probably that's why it is white, fluffy. These occur due to ischemia caused by capillary obliterations in severe hypertensive retinopathy. All these are severe hypertensive retinopathy. All this happens. Okay. Due to their cotton wool feathery appearance, they are also called as soft exudates, which is a misnomer. It is not an exudate, it's an infarct. Okay. So that is my cotton wool spot. What is it? It's an infarct. It is not it is not soft exudate. They will call it as soft exudate, but it is not actually an exudate. It is not coming out of these capillaries or something. It is an infarct because of ischemia. So this is all about benign or chronic hypertensive retinopathy, guys. You have survived this video. Good. So basically in this video, what have we seen? Benign or chronic hypertensive retinopathy. We have seen the situation in young people, why it happens, in old people, why it happens. Then we saw what are the features, the fundus changes we saw. Generalized arteriolar narrowing will be there. Focal arteriolar narrowing can be there. Arteriovenous nicking, this is very, very important. In this, you have seen Salus sign, bonnet sign, gun sign. Then arteriolar reflex changes, usually it will be bright and thin, linear blood reflex, but now it will become in grade 1 and grade 2, there will be more diffuse, less bright reflex. In grade 3, there will be copper wiring. In grade 4, there will be silver wiring. There can be superficial retinal hemorrhages, right? Superficial retinal hemorrhages, they will be flame-shaped. Flame-shaped, use these words. What shaped it is? Flame-shaped. Right, there can be hard exudates. Hard exudates, where will this be? In the outer plexiform layer, lipid deposits. These are what? Lipid deposits in outer plexiform layer. Right, then you have cotton wool spots. These are actually infarcts of what? Of the nerve fibers. Okay, this hemorrhages and exudates, they can disappear in few weeks. This one, hard exudate, guys, they also call it as macular fan, macular star. Okay, so many terminologies you have learnt in this video, so many terminologies actually. So let us look at the terminologies that you have learnt in this video. Can you list the terminologies, guys? So you saw some Salus sign, bonnet sign, gun sign, copper wiring. Where is that? Copper wiring, silver wiring, flame-shaped hemorrhage, hard exudates, which are called as macular fan, macular star, cotton wool spots. So all these are specific words that you have to write for benign or chronic hypertensive retinopathy. In the next video, we will look at the next topic, that is malignant hypertensive retinopathy. So please come back if you want to know about the malignant hypertensive retinopathy. Anyways, before concluding this video, we always will talk about the management. You will have to write this. If they ask benign, you will have to again write the management. Blood pressure control, cholesterol lowering, etc., etc. So let us look at in the next video the malignant hypertensive retinopathy and its management. Okay, that's all. Bye-bye.